Get it done! Get it done for Brooklyn, guys!
It'll be the Nets off the tip. As we get close to the All-Star break, Greg, what's the vibe like in the locker room post-trade deadline?
It's great if you're a playoff team and just knowing your GM wanted to keep you on the squad. Plus, you've got a little break coming up, so lots of happy dressing rooms right now.
And connects again from distance.
Nails it and is now even for the record.
Hard to believe, isn't it? His next shot from range will move him into the top spot all time for threes in a season.
And to think a few years ago, hitting 300 threes was impossible. Then Curry hits 402 in 2016, and just years later, the 402 plateau has been reached again. You just can't make this stuff up.
To the right side, Mr. Clutch. Good, another from three.
And who thought it couldn't be done? That three moving him into history.
Ah, you could feel it as soon as it left his hand. He is the king of the three and now stands alone. Alone at the top of the list.
And back in 2016, Curry had a year that I didn't think anyone could match. Until now. 402, no longer the high mark for threes in a season. The era of the long ball is truly upon us.
Harris with the ball for Brooklyn. 6-point game.
Boy, you think about a team that was as heavily laden with talent as the Brooklyn Nets were when they had Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, and James Harden. But obviously, injuries played a part. The big trade happens. A lot of bumps in the road for a roster that looked built to contend.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
Analytics say don't shoot the mid-range shot. Sometimes the best scorers are efficient in that area. Devin Booker, one of those guys.
Bridges passes to Irving. The 11-footer, that one a little long. Despite the Nets' shifting lineup stores, they're still fairly dominant.
Well, that's a credit to their organization. You have to be able to push aside the drama, shut out the noise, and when the ball is tipped, just focus on the game right in front of you.
From past the arc, and Curry pulls it down.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Now the pass to Irving. A three-pointer, no good.
Boy, just 1 for 4. A little brisky right now.
Booker the pass to Mr. Clutch. Now Crowder. Suns moving the ball around. Launches a three. That's good from Booker. On the assist from Crowder. Booker's got 5 now.
Well, you love Crowder's willingness to distribute the basketball. His vision allows him to set his teammates beautifully.
Bridges finds Irving. Back to Bridges. Left side, Irving. And again, no good by Brooklyn. So for Phoenix, their last game, a win against Detroit.
Yeah, proficiency from range, away from home, much easier said than done. They played a terrific ball game.
And I think it was clear that their plan was to attack from the three-point line, and it worked to perfection.
Bridges outside. And foul on the shot. So he'll get a
chance.
rotation played more.
Looking at who's out there now for the Nets. Ben Simmons, he's checked in for Nicholas Claxton. T.J. Warren comes in for Harris. Luke Kennard, he's checked in for Curry. And Edmund Sumner's subbed in for Irvin. Paul with the bucket.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
David Aldridge had a chance to catch up with head coach Monty Williams. David, what did he have to say?
Well, Kevin, I asked him, what are some of your main concerns? And he said, we're dealing with a team that can really light it up from the outside. So it's essential that we don't give them open looks from deep, or we'll be in trouble. Kevin?
Thanks, David. Devising a strategy to take away that three-point shot. Simmons can't get it to go. And here's Phoenix. They're on a 13-3 run. Mr. Clutch gets the bucket.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Simmons finds Warren. Simmons, a screen on Craig. There's the lob to Bridges. It's stolen by Johnson. Here's Mr. Clutch. Another field goal for him. 4 for 6 shooting tonight.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Simmons against Johnson. Ben Simmons gets the bucket.
Man, my goodness, the handle of Ben Simmons, the craftiness to get to his spot.
2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Out to the wing. Let's it go with a three. And that drops in from beyond the arc. Three-pointer from Mr. Clutch.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Warren, good.
They're so committed to scoring near the cup. T.J. Warren, nice touch.
Paul looking over the floor. Fires for three. Another three for Phoenix.
He's found his rhythm from deep, and you can see the confidence.
And I think the defender knows once he gets cooking, look out. The bucket looks awfully big to him right now.
And as the first quarter wraps up, already a double-digit lead. Suns lead by 17. 2K Sports back in a moment here in Brooklyn. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so far for the Suns.
We've got a bunch of this game yet to be played, but they're shooting it well from the three-point line. That's got to be a welcome sight.
You know, also, they've been incredible on the fast break, taking those chances, playing with great pace.
On the court right now, second quarter starting for the Suns. The wingmen are Booker and Johnson. Ayton is the pivot, and Crowder slides in at the four. And it's Mr. Clutch in the point guard.
Well, you have to understand what the defense is doing. If they give you an opportunity to set up a teammate, Luke Kennard will take it.
They set the pick. Simmons against Crowder. Johnson from outside. Good for the basket. Starting off 1 for 1 with that shot.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Kennard against Booker. From 12 feet out. You know, Greg, we know to win at the highest level, you need your star players to show up in the big games. With that in mind, what's the key?
You know, it's their will and their ability to fight. If you look at the great ones, even when things haven't gone their way, they continue to scratch and claw and do everything in their power to try and get the W.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Ayton. Brooklyn making it. This comes in for T.J. Warren. And Curry subbed in for Luke Kennard. Bridges, he's checked in for Phoenix. Last game for Brooklyn, they picked up the W against Los Angeles.
And guys, they walked into the arena with a certain kind of swagger, and we really saw it play out on the offensive end.
And what surprised me was how easy they made it look. It seemed like they got something out of every possession.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stuff.
Let's see if that serves as a momentum builder. What a great sequence for this group.
Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Well, Mr. Clutch in their last game against Detroit had a huge game. He tallied 25 points, and he got those points as he always does, knocking down shots from beyond the arc. And this is what we've come to expect. That performance demonstrated why he's in a league of his own. Kevin?
Thanks for the report, D.A. Greg, phenomenal effort by him in that last game.
He willed the team to victory through his talent and through that competitiveness.
Let's give credit to his teammates for continuing to find this guy. They knew he had the hot hand, and they were willing to ride it all night long.
Irving for three, hands it from downtown. Irving's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Yeah, field goal percentage above 50 now. Their offense is starting to show. And after all the drama and wanting out, Kyrie Irving remains a net. Feels like a bit of a farewell tour, but winning can heal all, and you never know what the future may hold, especially with Kyrie.
And that one's good, Irving.
I'll say he's playing with much more discipline here in the second quarter. He is waiting for good opportunities and capitalizing.
Here's the screen. Pass to Crowder. Beyond the arc. Second shot opportunity. And Ayton with the layup.
And Kevin, they dialed up their activity this quarter. We're seeing them convert a lot of those second chance opportunities.
And here's Irving. He had 28 points in the win against the Clippers.
And he was aggressive in how he played on the defensive side of the floor, notching 3 steals on the game.
On the clock, Curry outside, and it's Phoenix with the rebound.
Not quite enough defense that time around, just lucky he was off.
A three-pointer is right on target.
Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
Back to Irving. Curry on the wing. Defended by Booker. Here's Irving. It's Curry outside. And it's Ayton with the rebound. Ayton's got 6 rebounds now in the game. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Ayton, a screen on Harris. For three, Bridges. Offensive rebound. Pass to Mr. Clutch. No good from outside. Here's Harris. He had 16 points in the win against the Clippers. Irving for three. Connects from three-point range. Irving's got 10 points now just in this quarter.
Well, Kyrie Irving is very capable of single-handedly sustaining an offense. Hot hand, yes, sir.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Well, that three-point shot just gives you so much room to operate on the offensive end.
And
howdy, folks. I know you've all been clamoring to find out how the Rookie of the Year race is looking, and we are not letting you down.
Well, we know the chef always thinks he's the best rookie in the league, especially with the way he's played. He might be right. One-of-a-kind athlete in the league, full of elite talent.
Owens talks a big game, really does, but he's been able to back it up every step of the way. And keeping things moving, what a tremendous first-half performance for the Phoenix Suns. Thank you for being with us. Now let's send it to Kevin Harlan for the second half tip.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. What can you say, Mr. Clutch, an impressive effort here today?
Yeah, he's just been raining down on them from deep here. Talk about dialed in.
Well, the break certainly didn't have a cooling effect on him at all. He's in a great rhythm, looking comfortable and confident.
The guard set is Irving and Curry. Bridges out there with Joe Harris. And it's Claxton in at the five. And that's the group for Steve Nash as we begin the second half. Here's Ayton. Good. And a nice assist from Booker. Ayton's got the first basket of the third quarter for the Suns. Now here's Curry. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Outside Irving. There's the three.
Phoenix grabs the miss. Ayton's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Mr. Clutch's shot is off. And here's Curry, who brings it up for Brooklyn. They'll be playing host to Chicago for their next game. And they've been enjoying this long homestand. That will be game 4 of 5 in a row at home. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Kevin Durant learned an important lesson at age 11. His dad cooked him one-on-one, dunking on him and talking trash. Durant started crying and he locked himself in his room, but he came to realize, what am I so mad at? It's good to be passionate, but channel it. Once you're off the court, leave it and go back to being you. Kevin?
Great advice. David, thanks. Doris, when it comes to three-point shooting, Seth Curry has been a model of consistency.
Kevin, that's almost an understatement because he has not shot below 40% from three since a 2-game stint in the 2014-15 season. Think about it. This is how good it's been. 40% is actually low for Seth Curry. His career percentage is one of the highest of all time. Boy, that's 3 for 4 this half. You like that they're starting with a little bit of extra energy. Nice.
There's a screen. Bridges with it. Guarded now by Irving. Kicks it out to Booker. No good on the three.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
First team foul. Substitution.
Luke Kennard comes in for Curry. Called the Nets. Nets trail by 20. Now Warren, who provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. For the three. And no good on the last second attempt this time. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge...
38. The Suns.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Brooklyn's gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight, 5 of 12. I'm Phoenix, looking who they've got on the floor. Ayton is at the center with Johnson next to him. Paul out there with Mr. Clutch. And it's Craig in at the small forward. Irving kicks to Kurt. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Irving's got 3 assists now in this one.
Boy, had this shot on automatic. The confidence so crucial to what Seth Curry brings to the table. Yeah, in the first half, he was unstoppable from deep. Now 2 more since the break.
Here's Irving. That's his 6th field goal today, and that makes him now 6 for 11.
Boy, at the rim, an undersized guard, Kyrie Irving may be the best to ever do it.
That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And even down big, the effort and energy is still there to try and make a comeback. What an exhibition he's putting on today. This is about as hot as you can get.
Fourth quarter, still young, just over a minute play. Johnson with the rebound.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Well, all night he has made an impact at the offensive end. Now he's trying to shut the door.
Irving against Paul. Irving dishes to Kerr. Greg, we know a lot of teams using former NBA officials now working as consultants to teach their players how the refs see the game. I guess always looking for that edge.
Yeah, Kevin, I think it's a great idea because philosophically sometimes as the rules evolve, players got to learn how to evolve with them. So not getting the calls you might expect, also how you communicate with officials, I think all of that stuff plays a big role in just furthering that dynamic between the officials and the players.
Brooklyn needs to get off a shot here. It's up a 3. That one misses. And Phoenix the other way now. Here's Mr. Clutch. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Paul's got assist number 5 here tonight.
Yeah, great outside shooting, really fueling this run.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
The kick out to Irving. And again, it's the Nets missing. And it's Phoenix's ball. They're on an 11-2 run. It's sent back down by Simmons. Outside Curry. Back to Simmons. And Curry has it in the corner. Floats one up. Some solid defense from Ayton.
Never easy to stop this guy at the rim, but that is a beautiful contest right there.
Here's Mr. Clutch. Hits it from three-point range. Mr. Clutch has got 40 points.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
And guys, boy, when you're hitting, it sure does work. It obviously opens up major options at the offensive end.
Simmons passes to Irving. Right side Curry. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Irving can't hit.
It's really a tale of two quarters. Shot it so well in the last, but this one can't get anything to fall. And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Suns.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. And on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And this will now push it to a total of 44 games in the win column on the season.
Really, they had their number this season. 2 wins, a home win, and an away win.
And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Mr. Clutch.
What you love about his performance is that he is simply taking what the defense allows and then making the most of his opportunities.
Irving dishes to Curry. Back to Irving. Trying to get something going, and he sinks the layup.
If you get caught watching the ball against Kyrie, he's going to go right by you every time.
Here's Mr. Clutch, guarded by Kerr. Irving looking over the floor. So it's the Suns winning easily here. A resounding victory for them. And Greg, in enemy territory, no less.
Hey, that's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.